Pinder Brothers was established in 1877 by two brothers, John Thomas Griffith Pinder and Charles Edward Pinder, who set up business as silversmiths and electroplaters. Pinder Brothers became a limited liability company in 1920, and in the 20s John William Pinder and his son Alan took over the firm. Alan encouraged his father to push through plans for a new works in Arundel Street, Sheffield. The site opened in 1939, where Pinder Brothers remains today.
I've done this for the last 30 years. I don't think there's so many people that can do what I do now. It can be improved by computers because you get a tag handle and it's there. What you've got to do is see the shape and the colour and the texture, and then form it and put it to a head. A computer wouldn't improve it at all. The future is, I hope, where things go in circles. Stags becoming more popular and we're seeing a bit more interest. I honestly believe a lot of things that I've made over the years are still in use today. 30 years ago when I first come, stag was a massive. It died out in the late 70s and 80s, but now it's coming back, so hopefully there's a resurgence. I'd love to go and see the hotels and places like that, what I've made things for, and just see how they've still been used.
The appeal of working for Pinders is based on working from scratch, from sheet metal and being your own boss, being able to develop it in your own style, or develop styles designed brought in from all over the world, developing it so that you get what they want and it's still handmade, and that's the secret really. When these products go around the world, they're still sold as handmade products.